Rahui Katini.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. As the MP for Te Taitunga, I am very proud to stand in support of the Canterbury Earthquake Recovery Bill. This is an important bill which sets out the appropriate measures to enable the Minister for Canterbury Earthquake Recovery Authority to facilitate and direct, if necessary, Greater Christchurch and its communities to respond to and recover from the impacts of the Canterbury earthquakes. There has been so much said already about the events of 22 February that one wonders what can be left to say. And the bill itself puts this into words. We simply did not have the capability to deal with a disaster of this magnitude. But what has been so remarkable as the days and weeks have unfolded is to see that there is indeed incredible resilience and fortitude at every level of the response to this disaster. The key issue is that no one player should or could be expected to respond with a timely and coordinated recovery effort for the Greater Christchurch region. As a leader of the recovery effort, I am pleased to know that Ngāi Tahu has supported central government intervention because, in their view, the range of the issues emanating from the tragedy have a scale and a complexity that is beyond any one institution to resolve. In my consultations with Ngāi Tahu, I am aware that they are confident that a close collaborative arrangement with the CERA will both deliver positive outcomes for Christchurch and enable Ngāi Tahu to meaningfully contribute to the recovery program. Ngāi Tahu submit that a bold but considered central government intervention is required due to the scale and complexity of the issues affecting Canterbury at this time. While this legislation does not have a treaty clause, it embodies the treaty partnership, and the Māori Party joins with Ngāi Tahu in strongly valuing this approach. And I want to state from the outset that perhaps one of the most important achievements for the Māori Party wants to draw the House's attention to is Clause 40B of the Bill. In this clause, the bill states that nothing in this Act affects the operation of the Ngāi Tahu Claims Settlement Act 1998, and that, in fact, if there is any situation of doubt, the Chief Executive must exercise his or her power in accordance with the Ngāi Tahu Claims Settlement Act 1998. The Māori Party has advocated for the first right of refusal regarding land disposal. This is important in respect of protecting the integrity of treaty settlements. In essence, the Canterbury Earthquake Recovery Bill makes explicit the primacy of Ngāi Tahu Claims Settlement Act. Now, why this is so important is not just about demonstrating the government has agreed that the existing first right of refusal are sacrosanct and should be protected, but it also demonstrates the care taken in respect of formalising the treaty relationship with Mana Whenua. And I'm pleased to bring to the House the views of Ngāi Tahu, that they seek to commend the leadership shown by this government in enacting legislation that provides for the iwi to assume a key role in the recovery of the people and place. The advice that we have received from Ngāi Tahu expresses their particular appreciation of the way in which this legislation embodies the commitment of Ngāi Tahu to be a partner with central and local government in developing the recovery strategy. The Māori Party has played a key role in promoting the importance of government formalising a partnership with Ngāi Tahu, with both central and local government, a relationship which will be given effect in the development of the CBD recovery plan. The Māori Party promotes the creation of the CERA and consultation with Ngāi Tahu and locals in regards to the recovery strategy and plans, notwithstanding that this is limited to consultation and collaboration. Finally, at this first reading of the bill, I want to share some of the vital data and statistics that underpins successful implementation of this bill. The bill is founded on the need for community participation in decision-making processes while balancing this against the need for a timely and coordinated recovery process. And I want to share some of the amazing achievements that I have been privileged to participate in through a unique development which I think of as the Iwi Māori sector response. The Māori Party strongly advocates for a recovery strategy that is culturally appropriate for Māori. What we have seen unfold in Christchurch is a crisis response effort to support Māori and the wider community, particularly those in Christchurch's eastern suburbs, through a collaboration between a number of iwi and Māori organisations known as the Iwi Māori Recovery Network. The Iwi Māori Recovery Network is a collaboration supported by Te Runanga o Ngāi Tahu. Within this, all of the whānau support has been done by whānau order providers in Christchurch and other providers from a number of iwi and Māori from outside of the region, including Te Arawa, Tainui, Ngāti Raukawa and Ngāti Whātua. The contributions of this network are total number of contacts as is Tuesday, 8 April 2011, 9,493. Whānau with home safety concerns, 161. Whānau requesting food parcels, 550. Whānau requesting water, 513. Whānau needing medical attention, 211. Whānau needing clothing, bedding, etc., 132. Whānau needing transport, 76. Whānau needing assistance with filling out paperwork, 31. Whānau needing counselling, 106. Whānau needing respite for family, 19. Whānau needing assistance with clean-up labour, 69. Whānau members registered with Red Cross, 1,518. Whānau members registered with WINS, 1,113. The Waitene Māori have played a particularly significant role in this collaboration as they have conducted house-to-house visits, and we are all enormously grateful for their efforts. Mr. Speaker, I wanted to break down this detail into actual numbers because it demonstrates to me the real mahi that is being done every day on the ground, what this bill embraces and addresses. The bill formalises the need to ensure local involvement and decision-making with the Minister for Canterbury Earthquake Recovery and the authority to work alongside the Christchurch City Council, Environmental Canterbury, Waimakariri District Council, Selwyn District Council and Te Runanga o Ngāi Tahu, businesses and community interests and the private sector, in order that the planning processes under the bill take into account local views and the views of those who are most affected. There will also be a consultation process with locals. The planning recovery of the Greater Christchurch region will occur through the development of a long-term recovery strategy, which will be developed by the Canterbury Earthquake Recovery Authority in consultation with the organisations previously mentioned and Te Runanga o Ngāi Tahu. The bill is an essential part of the recovery of the area. We are happy to support it and look forward to active participation throughout the ensuing debate.
Nikki Wagner.